can't believe Jamie went and got a haircut. I need a haircut.
I thought ready, wheelies.
I thought the Taliban didn't allow you to have your sides that short.
They do now. New rules. So this is a Screamin' Eagle setup. We're going to high compression 114 pistons. The pistons that Harley has, one of the leading manufacturers in pistons is Mal. If you look at the very bottom of the piston, underneath the skirt, it'll show you there. Here's a look, the factory piston compared to the new high compression. High compression piston has a dome in here that's raised up a little bit to give it a little more squeeze in the combustion chamber. Therefore, it increases the compression on the motor.
Big benefits to gear drive cam. The original cam drive setup is run off of these two sprockets with a chain. The chain has a tensioner that keeps it tensioned, because tensioners tension. And that's driven by oil. Well, although the hydraulic setups are very, very proficient, there still is a possibility of oil failure or tensioner failure relating in. We don't want to talk about that. Speaking of cams, we're going to install an S&S gear drive 475 lift cam on here. And I just happen to have a cam in my pocket. This is a stock cam out of a Milwaukee 8. And this is the gear drive S&S. And isn't that impressive? Super, super dope. We're gonna do Screamin' Eagle lifters, some Screamin' Eagle quick install push rods. You gotta keep shit bolted down around here. We wanna talk about good stuff. Well, you agree, this is a nice video. This is a family video. The gear drive cams not only eliminate the need for the tensioners and the chain, but they also eliminate parasitic drag because all of the pressure kept on the chain helps or tries to stop it from moving. The gear turns like this. Oh, are we on?
We're on.
And I wish Jamie would have let me get a haircut. Our general manager, Jamie Lima, was gonna do all the talking because he's very handsome and very sure of himself and has a glorious beard. But he got a haircut today. And time waits for no man. So we're moving forward. One of the critical components to installing gear drive cams on a twin cam or a Milwaukee 8 engine is the crankshaft runout. We have an indicator set on the crankshaft. I like to turn it off with a wheel to make sure that the crankshaft is moving as freely as possible. And you need to have under 5,000ths runout total. And on this one, we're at 3.5, so we're well within spec. So we're going for it. We don't care. We're doing it. Come on, time's money. Hey. I got another gig after this one. We got to do this. You notice, even with brand new cylinders?
Yeah, absolutely.
Look at all the grime that comes out of there. You always want to wash them. Use white paper rags, and I wash them until it comes out clean.
So Mike already has the cylinders all cleaned up. We have a ring in here. So what we're going to do, even though they should be factory gap, is we're going to check everything that Harley's done just to make sure they're within the spec that they need to be within. So what we'll do is we'll have a feeler gauge go in the middle, make sure that the gap is exactly where the specs are that Harley Davidson has recommended, and then we'll run it.
I would just set it up where it's going to sit inside the... Man. These small pistons are super consistent every single time. No exception. Hello. Welcome back. So before we were talking about the tensioner that tensions, so there's tension on the tensioned chain. This is the tensioner. It fills with oil, which keeps this plunger stiff and keeps this material pushed against that chain. And inside the back, you can see there's a little passage of oil to keep the hydraulic plunger stiff so that it doesn't do this. Well, because we're doing this gear drive cam, now we have to deal with this. That's the hole in the cam plate that the oil is going to come out. But S&S engineers are top notch and they thought of everything. We're gonna take this plate and we're gonna put it right there.
Where?
Right there. Jamie got his haircut.
I'm ready. Need some tools.
He looks very
horsepower.
I'm
ready. Wheelies.
I thought the Taliban didn't allow you to have your sides that short.
They do now. New rules.
Oh. No one said anything about lighting. So this is the gear drive system that replaces this chain. So there's no possibility of failure. There's no parasitic draw. Everything rotates freely now, which is why you do the gear drive cam. The last step in the gear drive is to measure the gear lash itself. And there's a spec in the S&S paperwork. I'll hook up my dial indicator, make sure that our gear is in spec. If it's not, you can actually order a different gear to make sure it is in spec. I have a feeling this one will be okay. I just need an interpreter. S&S sent us the paperwork in Spanish.
Right.
So. Jamie, this is in Spanish. So we're right at 1,000 in all four quadrants of the circle, which is great. The spec is 5/10,000ths to 2/1,000ths, so we're right where we want to be. Cool. Might have a little bit of a whine to it, but nothing.
Oh, that's normal. Where that whine would come from.
If it's too tight, it'll whine. If it's too loose, it'll clatter, because you'll actually hear the gear shake back and forth like this.
Right, right.
So a lot of times when people say their gear drives are noisy, they can hear that.
All right, now we're gonna go over our exhaust setup for this build. One of the main concerns we've been having with these bikes when customers are trading them in, they're coming off of a twin cam or an Evo, and we're getting a Milwaukee 8. The motor makes great horsepower, big torque out of the box, but it's a smoother motor, so it's a smoother sounding motor. So when we install those S&S cams, it really increases the lope, gets a lopey idle that we're used to, and that's what we all want. Not only that, when you get on it, it's gonna bark. So what D&D has done on the new Milwaukee 8 pipe, if you look closely, is it's a step header. It goes from one size tube to a larger tube to a larger tube. That definitely helps in getting a torque curve. It's going to one merge collector. A 2-in-1 pipe is always gonna increase your torque down low on any exhaust system that you put on the Harley Davidson. With the new Street Glide Specials having the cutouts in the back for the bags, D&D solved that problem by putting a falsy pipe so you get all the benefits you have in a 2-in-1 system, but you have the looks of a true dual system. And if you go to the other side, their pipe actually goes all the way and almost matches up. It's about 3/4 of an inch to connecting to the pipe on your right-hand side.
You know, I always feel like I'm being watched. It's starting to get on my nerves. So now we've installed this sexy D&D 2-in-1 pipe that Jamie was talking about earlier. And we've also downloaded Power Vision map into the computer. We like to do our dyno tuning with Power Vision because I truly believe that it is the best tuning device on the market for Harley Davidsons. Also, a quick disclaimer on this engine. Earlier in the video, you saw the quick install push rods. Those are utilized if you're going to install a cam directly without taking the heads off. However, S&S has designed this cam to be able to be used with the stock springs and push rods, and since we removed the heads, we did not install those. There was no need, so we didn't put the extra expense into the build. Now, I suppose we'll just lower this beast and fire it up. Tune this bad boy and publish the results, unless they're not good, and then the video ends right here.
Here, right there.
Right? Shit. I'll stand here?
Yeah.
I'll stand here.
Only your torso.
Those are the pistons. And this isn't working for me. Did it cut?
No.
Give me some light. My eyebrows all right?
Your eyebrows are perfect, actually. Okay. I had eyebrow envy.
Nobody, Charlie, the lighting guy. It's my,
Charlie's talking to you. Turn the light on.
Yeah. Okay. On. Oh, there it is.
Here we go.
Okay, look, man, I'm tired. I'm done.
Here we go.
Look at this guy. Hey, how many horses can you hook together on an Amish cart?
As many as it takes.
How many do you actually have?
Well, I don't know. How many do you need?
I don't know. It's your buggy. Two? You got two horses?
You're the one pulling.
Bike's pulling. Anyways, back to this. What's this again?